Welcome back to onestoptutorials.com. Ali is here again. How you doing, guys and girls? We're so close now. We're so close to the end. I can feel the power. I'll tell you what, I've had some great emails lately. I've had some people who have completed the build your own eBay template, and they have sent me their links and are telling you, you guys and girls out there are better than me. You're making some beautiful templates, some beautiful websites. Keep at it. It does get easier. It starts to make sense after a while, and then it doesn't seem so Japanese or Swahili as it first does when you get started building websites and stuff like that. Just playing around with it, obsessing with it, and you really can do it, and you'll be saving yourself a lot of money in the process, okay? So hang in there. So carrying on from the last tutorial, we got up to getting all of our HTML div code in. We put all that code in. Look, this is what we did. Ooh, all the way down in here. That's the code we put in. Look at that. Excellent, okay? So now we're going to get into our CSS and make it look a bit more convincing, okay? So back to our style sheet, our best friend, our style sheet. I love these styles, okay? So what we want to do first is we need to call upon some of our div IDs and div classes we named. So let's start at the top. Div ID news container, and that is the ice cream man just going past. Okay, let him go, making all that noise. Div ID news container. So back to our style sheet. Anytime it's an ID, what is it? Good on ya, pound sign. So let's call this a news underscore container because that's what we made our div to be. Open and close brackets. So what do we want to do? First, we're going to mess around with this one first. What I want to do is in the last, in this section here, I floated this to the left. So we might as well float all this to the right, okay? So float, which means it's just going to float it across to the right. Okay, looking good. Let's have a look. Made any difference at all? Yep, there it is. So it's got us into some form of line. At least we're on the right hand side, but it's too small. So let's add a width. Okay, and I wrote down this width actually. I know what it is. That's cheating, I know, but I know what it is. It needs to be 290 pixels. Okay, let's have a look. Bang, fits in there, lovely jubbly, as they say, Del Boy. We did that size because we've already set another style. I think it was the actual. Let me have a look. I think it was the content area, content wrap. We set it to 980. We actually set the size of this whole left area here to a certain size. So the reason we make this 290 is that's what's left over from the whole of the actual layout, okay? It's just a little bit of maths and I cheated, so I already know what it is. So the next thing I want to do here is I actually want to add a background color, okay? So let's get right back into it. The background color that I want to choose is a background color. And I'm going to type in my own, okay? I'm going to make it E-E-E-E-E-E. Okay, let's have a look, see if it's actually done anything. And there it is. It's that sort of grey, sort of different colour. Grey, different colour. It's just grey colour, okay? And what I might also do in this one is I might add some padding here. And I'm going to show you a different way of doing this. Remember, we did the four coordinates before. But I'm going to do it this way. I'm going to do padding. Padding top. Wait a minute, I missed the G. Padding top. Let's add 2 pixels. Padding right. And 0 pixels. Padding bottom. Let's make the bottom one. Let's make it 20 pixels. Give it a nice bit of space and padding, padding left. And I'm gonna make that 0 pixels. So as you can see, we've done it a different way this time. We could have done the four coordinates, okay? We've done it a different way, and let's have a look. Does it look like it's done anything? Is it, how are we looking here? So as you can see, we got our padding 20 at the bottom here, okay? We then made padding right 0, padding left 0, because we didn't want it pushing the template at all. and then we made a padding, I don't know if you can see it at the top here, of 2 pixels. Okay, so that's our padding looking nice and tidy. So I reckon for the time being I'm pretty okay with the news container. Next thing I want to do is do the actual news. Okay, and we made the news to be a class. What am I doing? News. Okay, and open and close brackets, and the news is this section here. It's this in the original, this big blue section here. So we got some writing in there, we got some background color in there. So let's get straight into that. So the news, as I floated the container right, I'm going to stick in a clear both, okay, because we have used a float at the right above it. So it's just, I'm going to stick it in there just to be safe. Okay, next thing I want to do is I want to adjust that font. So let's make it a font size, and I want to make it 18 pixels. We're just going to make it bigger. Okay, semicolon. Let's make I don't know if I've shown you this one, I can't remember, but this is called letter, I think I did show you, letter spacing, and we're just going to spread the words out a little bit. So let's make that 2 pixels. We then need a color of the actual the font. Okay, and I'm going to make a color of, and I'm going to type in my own because here's one I made earlier, D8 D7 D7. Okay, that's a gray color, and that's fine because we're actually going to be putting a blue background on it in a sec. Okay, the height, let's make the height, what was it, I think it was 20 pixels, height 20 pixels. Okay, and let's add some good old padding, and you remember this 2 coordinate digits I told you before. The first one is top and bottom, 10 pixels, and the second one is left and right, 20 pixels. Okay, so that's the padding, that's that. And I might actually just quickly put our background color, and I'm gonna type in our own. I'm gonna do the pound sign, and it is 1E4B74. Okay, and I actually had a question from someone, does it matter if you put capitals or lowercase? Nope, it doesn't matter. You could type all that in capitals or lowercase, and it seems to just work fine. Let's have a look at how we're looking. Look at that, we're here, we got our blue space in. Okay, and as you can see, we've added our padding, which allowed us to move the text across. If we didn't add that padding, this news and events would have been really tight up in the left corner here. But by adding that padding, we've managed to really, you know, move it down nice. 10 pixels, let's go back to the star. 10 pixels top and bottom, 20 pixels left and right. This is our background color that we made. We made the font size of 18 pixels and a letter spacing of 2 pixels. If you remember in the other tutorial, if I make this, let's make this 0, and you'll see what I mean. You'll see that the words are closer together. And by adding this 2 pixels, okay, you'll notice now we just get that spreading. If you wanted to add a different font for this, all you would need to do is do font family, and then choose which one you want, and that will, this means if they don't have Arial, then it will go onto this one. If they don't have this one, then it will go onto this one. Okay, and as you can see, it looks a bit nicer with the Arial. We are really booming along here. We're so close to the end now. As you can see, by adding that float right, it made all the difference in the world. If I where was it? We made that float right in the news container. It just moved everything right. I just love floats. Floats make your life so easy. But remember, when you use a float, right or left, add a clear both as well. And because that's what it's for, clear both, which will allow you to wrap, carry on wrapping around and not get stuck. And yeah, that's it for this tutorial. In the next tutorials, we're going to be carrying on. We're going to make the news section. We're going to get this section here done. We're going to add some fictitious text again. Get this done. Hopefully it'll be one more tutorial. Any questions, let me know. I've been getting some unbelievable questions, unbelievable comments as well. I thank everyone out there for watching these tutorials, because it makes me keep moving forward and keep trying to teach you this stuff. Okay, take it easy, guys and girls. Catch you with the next one-stop tutorials.